if you take a pie chart of the number of different compounds made in nature, 3/4 of that pie comes from plants. Plants are ultimately going to be the solution to many of our problems. I am Dean DellaPenna. I'm a faculty member in the Department of Biochemistry and Molecular Biology in the College of Natural Sciences. I'm a university distinguished professor and was recently named MSU Foundation Professor. One of the biggest problems on the planet is not receiving the required number of vitamins and minerals in your diet. One of the most well-known is vitamin A deficiency, and this is caused by low levels of beta-carotene in the diet. And this is because the major crops that we feed the planet with, wheat, rice, maize, are woefully deficient in beta-carotene. We've discovered one enzyme in plants that is involved in degrading beta-carotene. And so when we shut down that enzyme, we increase beta-carotene levels 15-fold. The good news is we can actually modify those crops so that instead of causing malnutrition, they can actually alleviate it. Several of us have been working on 14 different medicinal plants to try to understand the biochemistry involved in their medicinal compounds that they produce. And this is important because over half of the medicines that we take are either derived from plants or are inspired by compounds, molecules that are made in specific plants. What we'd like to be able to do is to identify those 20 or 30 specialized genes that make these compounds that we use as medicine so that we could actually use them to synthesize them much more cheaply. MSU is one of the best places in the world for plant biology, and plant biochemistry is really committed to maintaining us at that level. Over the past 2 decades, funding for sciences in the U.S. has really declined. What that means is a lot of very good ideas get left on the table and never get funded. Endowed chairs and the foundation professorships can play an important role, and they allow me and others to fund some of what are our best, although potentially riskiest ideas, but ones that have potential to have high payoff.